know that I just finished a shooting board. This here's the project. The shooting board is made from MDF. I chose MDF because the MDF is a much more stable product than just normal wood. And it's cheap. It's relatively inexpensive. I think the board I bought with this was $5. I chose the size and dimensions basically so that I would have enough room to use as a not only a shooting board with the track on the side, but I could also use it as a bench hook for cross-cutting on the edge. The shooting board is relatively simple. Pretty much the only purpose of it is you take a board like this that you've cut. If I look at it right now, it's fairly square. There's really not a lot of inconsistency in the end. So it's pretty close, but I want to make sure that it's perfect. So the way that I do that is I put the board on my fence here. Use my plane. I use a lie-nielsen number 7. It's a long plane, so it allows me plenty of surface to grip against the sides. By taking the board, putting pressure not only back, but also sideways into the plane, I push it tight against there. And then all I simply do is slide the plane in the track. And it's simple as that. I check. Looks like I've got it pretty well, but there's a few little marks at the bottom. Looks like still where I need just a little bit more to continue on. One more time. Looks like that about does it. And now we have a perfect cut. The shooting board is to use it as a bench hook. By using it as a bench hook, you can allows you to hold your wood in place while you do a cross cut. By the construction of it with the piece on the bottom to hold it tight against the bench, and then you've got the top rest up here, you're allowed to hold the wood on it with a lot of pressure on it to hold it in place so it doesn't give while you're doing a cross cut. All right, thanks for stopping by, and we'll see you next time.